Welcome to the UGC lecture series in computer science. In this series of lectures, we have been looking at the subject software engineering. In today's session, we will be looking at the management spectrum in software engineering. The objectives of today's session include, first we will try to understand the importance of 4 P's, which we will be later describing as people, process, project and product. And we are also to study about the roles and responsibilities of various people who got involved in the project development. And I will also talk about how to meld the process and the product. And finally, why do the systems fail or indicate how software projects fail? In my initial lectures, I have told you more than 54% of the software goes to failure primarily because of the reason of any one of the failures that has happened in all these 4 P's. So, we will look at that in detail. If you ask a question of what is management spectrum, here comes the literal explanation of what management spectrum means. Management spectrum describes the management of software or how to make a project successful. So, in an organization, in what capacity the project is being successful? Is it the role of the people who got involved, or is it the role of the product that has been developed by these people got involved? So, we may have to look at those things. So, we try to focus on 4 P's, as I have said. These 4 P's are nothing but people, product, process and project. So, they are interrelated to each other. People, process, product and project are all interrelated to each other. Talking more about the spectrum, this is more towards project management technique. A manager of a project has to control all these 4 P's. Being a manager, it is not an easy task to look after the software project management, and at the time of modularization, not the developer will get totally involved in the project and try to modularize, rather develop and test on their own. So, it is not the responsibility of only the people who got involved in the development process, rather the next higher level body will also have to continuously monitor. Not just the higher level body, there are certain responsibilities, roles and responsibilities which people might have to take, so that every project given for a company is been a success. So, at one point, initial project that was taken by the company is validated against successful projects. Later on, how many successful projects have been delivered of the total number of projects that were given is becoming the another metric whereby we can proceed giving continuous work. So, managers of the project has to control all these P's to have a smooth flow in the project progress and to reach the goal. This order of P's are not arbitrary. Let us look at what people concentrate on every piece. To start with the people first. People factor is very much important in the process of software development. There are following areas in the software people like, starting from the recruitment, right set of people have to be recruited for the software to be implemented, selecting them on a particular criteria on what their skill sets are. Then we will be looking at the performance management, we will be giving them appropriate training in the field that they are going to work. The team has to efficiently coin down all these details and fix a appropriate compensation for them, compensation in terms of salaries, provide appropriate compensation for them, and the scope for development, career development also to be looked at for every people who got involved in the project. Not just the career development of the individual, how does the organization benefit through this person? So, as part of people development, organization also tries to develop, and we will have work design too in this. And team culture development, how these people are getting acquainted with the team activity. So organizations achieves high level of maturity in people management area. So the level of maturity, as we have seen in terms of capability maturity model, is assessed not just by the overall organizational strength, rather it is also to look at the people who got involved with the project. As I have told you clearly, people being the prime factor for the successful delivery of the project, but then who has to do what? Having recruited 100 people, given 100 people for the project, are they all of equal criteria or equal category? Then it comes, we will assign the roles and responsibilities of every person who got involved in the project. So people are the most important element for the success of software project. I am insisting again that these people play a primary role for the success of the project. So people participate in the project with different capacities, starting from senior manager. A senior manager has to define the business issues that often have significant influence on the project. So what are the issues that pop out? It can be of any sort. These issues will pop out at any time. So the senior managers have to take an appropriate decision, because at the junior level, developers may not be aware of such constraints. So it is the responsibility of the senior manager who got involved. So these business issues that often have significant influence. So there should be an influence on the project, which the decision might have been taken from the senior manager's end. And there is another person who is called a project manager or a technical manager, who must plan, motivate, organize and control the practitioners who do software work. So any person who is responsible of taking lead of people who are under the technical category and who are under the personal category, managing their stuffs and taking it to the next level by motivation. Not just by motivation, they have to plan this activity very clearly so that it is taken to the next step. At times, we may have to organize each and every activity separately, which has to be assigned to whom or also to be discussed, and finally taking charge of the work that has been delegated. So we may have to have complete control over that too. And we have people called practitioners who deliver the technical skills that are necessary to engineer a product or application. So practitioners are supposed to be the people who got involved for pure technical purpose for the development of the product or an application. And we have some more called customers who specify the requirements for the software to be engineered, and other stakeholders who have been peripheral interest in the outcome. So as a customer, I might need the product of this sort. So given a specification, I may vary the specification as a stakeholder, or I myself would give a specification which my software team, who are technically expertised on this particular field, will try to develop and give it back to me. Then in that case, customers are totally involved. I may have to manage a very good communication with the customers. I have another role called end users, who interact with the software once it is released for production use. The volume of end users are very important. How many people are getting used to the system are very important. What kind of quality we deliver to them is very important. At what time we deliver to them is also equally important. So end users are supposed to be the buyers of this particular product or users of the software, but then these people, starting from senior manager, project manager, practitioners, customers, everybody get involved among themselves so that it reaches them at the right time, right place, with right quality. Continuing on with further roles, we have somebody called team leader, where the qualities of a team leader need to be, they have to motivate. Motivation is nothing but the ability to encourage technical people to produce their best ability. So, what is their best ability? We may have to bring out those best abilities in the practitioners, make complete use of them, and try to control at times whenever it is required and utilize that for the organization's benefit. And we have organization, the ability to mold existing processes that will enable the initial concept to be translated into a final product. So, how do the practitioners help the system to build and form a final deliverable, in what format it has to be delivered? So, how it has to be delivered, those final products are decided here, for which we need right organization. We have something called ideas or innovation, where the ability to encourage people to create and feel creative even when they must work within bounds established for a particular software product or an application. So, everybody will come with their own innovative ideas. This helps more often in research and development kind of a place, where they have their own ideas which they wanted to productize. On the other way around, if at all you are asked to develop a software, the customers might have given a requirement with a mindset which the customer has got initially. Specification would have been defined by the customer. In case the development team has an idea of coming about with a new idea which can be brainstormed along with the customer, which can be brainstormed along with their team members, and this idea can be approved by the customer or the stakeholder, then it can be taken to the next level. Rather, as part of the idea, there can be innovations also that can happen and which may be of unique interest by the customers who wanted the product. Effective project manager emphasizes on four different key points. If I am a project manager, let's try to emphasize on certain gray areas like problem solving. Given a problem, what could be the preferable solution by the stakeholder? Which solution might be acceptable by most of the end users? So, problem solving plays a vital role here. Managerial identity. How good he has the capacity of planning, organizing, and delivering, taking complete charge or control of the entire system that is to be developed. That shows the amount of managerial capacity that an individual has got. Not just that, achievement, what percentage of achievement, how much of achievement that a person has carried out is being qualitative enough. Then influence and team building. So, binding a team and making this product real time becomes the toughest task ever. Individually, every human being might be very good at their own technical skills, but integration plays a dominant role here. How am I when I am interacting with somebody else in my team? How am I when I am interacting with my team leader in my own development team? So, this team building activity has to be taken complete charge, and it is the primary responsibility of a project manager. Talking about the software team, the best team structure depends on three things. One is on the management style of the organization. So, what style we follow for the organization, whether it is top down or bottom up or given more of people centric approach, sandwich type, all these things are prevailing, but then how much value, what style we follow in the organization is very predominant, is to be given utmost importance. So, the number of people who got involved in the project and their skill levels. Skill set plays a vital role. Being a technical person in the software development industry, the skill set of appropriate people is very much essential. So, number of people who got involved in the project and their skill sets are to be assessed properly. and overall problem difficulty. So, what level of difficulty the practitioners try to encounter, how good are we at solving all these technical difficulties. Some of the following factors are to be considered for planning the structure of software engineering teams. The difficulty of problem to be solved, so problem solving capacity, the size of the software to be considered. Many a times people may not look at the number of lines of code that we write. It can be in kilo lines of code, it can be in more than that. I can be proud of saying I have written 1 lakh lines of code, but then does it intended to do for the purpose is a big, very big question mark. So, I am to write a size of the software which should be remarkable enough so that it is meeting the essential needs of all my end users and it meets the requirement given by my customer. So, the time that the team will stay together, how long the team has to take place. See, sometimes you may be doing some projects for people who are sitting abroad. So, we may have to integrate with them at times where we will try to discuss with them what kind of activity they do and where we have to continue. So, this flexibility of delivery is very much essential. So, the degree of communication required for the project, the quantum of communication that we maintain between our own team members is very much essential. So, there ends the first possible P, which is people. Again, I am trying to repeat, if we could satisfy people, then they can take this project to the next level. So, people are not just at one level, people at all levels, if they are satisfied, it can be taken to next level. But then there are essential techniques that we may have to follow so that they will also consider the organizational's growth. The second subsequent thing is on the product. So, before a project can be planned, product objectives and the scope should be established. So, what are the objectives, what is the motivation behind why we develop such a product, and that has to be sold in the market. So, the product objectives and scope are very much essential. Initially, we may have to design that, we may have to calibrate on that so that it goes in a right sense. What could be the possible alternative solution should be considered, and technical and management constraints should also be parallelly identified. So, without this information, it is impossible to define reasonable estimates of the cost, an effective assessment of risk, a realistic breakdown of project task, or a manageable project schedule. So, assessing on the project needs initial framing of objectives and the scope, but then the outcomes that we expect on the project are the cost, the volume of risk that got involved, how are we to work on the work breakdown structure and project schedule. So, in order to meet all this, we may have to preliminarily plot an objective and the scope so that it could reach all these at the later stages. So, objectives primarily identify the overall goals for the product, without considering how these goals will be achieved. It need not be a case where I might employ some algorithm, preferable ways of solving the problem, but then we may have to need or provide the objective with which we have started doing this project. So, motivation is the first point that we have to talk about. Then, after understanding the project thoroughly, we may have to coin down the objectives with which we will start so that we will achieve this as a goal. Not just the objective, we are also about to look at the scope, which identifies the primary data, functions, and behaviors that characterize the product. Once the product objectives and scope are understood, alternative solutions are considered. That means, from available various alternatives, managers and practitioners, we may have to select which approach will be the best approach. Now, coming to the third component called process, a software process provides the framework from which a comprehensive plan for software development can be established. So, we can plan what is to be executed at what point in time only with the objectives and scope being clearly defined. So, a smaller number of framework activities are applicable to all software projects regardless of their size or complexity of the project. A number of different tasks, milestones, work products and quality assurance points enable the framework activities to be adopted to the characteristics of the software project and the requirements of the project team. And finally, there will be a list of umbrella activities such as software quality assurance, software configuration management and measurement overlaying the process model. There are a list of team software process which got involved, there are a list of personal software process which got involved. Team is like an umbrella where many people get involved, but then management is one particular person's responsibility to take it to the next level. So, although different people are involved, but then the holds or the hands of the management authority will hold the umbrella at the bottom where it is a responsibility which guides or motivates each and every employee in the organization to take the project to the next level. So, software process with framework activities, the generic framework phrases that characterize software process, definition, development and support are applicable to all the software irrespective of whatever it might be. So, the problem is to select the process model that is appropriate for the software to be engineered by a project team. The project manager must decide which process model is most appropriate. We might have already seen the different software development lifecycle models, starting from waterfall model, spiral model, win-win spiral model, prototyping model and many other things. But then which model suits the requirements given by the customer becomes mandatory here. So, I will have to look at how these models would best suit to the requirements as posted by the customer. So, we must decide which process model is most appropriate for the customer who have requested the product and the people who will do the work, characteristics of the product itself, the project environment in which the software team works. When a process model has been selected, the team then identifies a preliminary project plan. So, I may have to sketch a project plan that best fits at every stage so that what will be delivered, the time estimate can be easily sketched. So, the preliminary project plan based on the set of common processes, framework activities are established. And last, the project, we conduct planned and controlled software projects for one primary reason, it is only known to manage the complexity. So, a software manager and the software engineer who build the product must avoid some common warning signs, say understand the critical success factors that lead to a good project management and develop a common sense approach for planning, monitoring and controlling. Although these are supposed to be the project management activities, but then these are some of the essential methodologies, essential key points that a manager has to follow, where every project is measurable, every project has to be planned properly, everything should be monitored and every project has to be controlled at the right sense. And the manager has to apply his common sense so that it has been taken over completely. So, within the project, we have four organizational paradigms. First paradigm, first of its kind, would be a closed paradigm where this represents a traditional hierarchy of the team. The team work well for producing software based on past efforts, but it failed to work for innovative ideas. There will be something called a random paradigm. This is a loosely structured and depends upon individual initiative to team members. This performs well when innovations are required, but performs poorly when orderly performance is required. See, random as the name indicates, we may have to place this and that at different points in time. So, we may not be able to align or rather structure it as appropriate, but then the team members have to work. Sometimes this happens during agility too. When we are talking about agility also, people might have been disorganized, but then it is the responsibility of the one of the person in the project who can take it in a structured format. And third of its paradigm type will be open paradigm, where it attempts to structure a team in such a way that some controls are achieved using closed paradigm, but innovations are required using the random paradigm. So, most of it during the open paradigm category are done using closed paradigm, but then there should be lot of innovations which should come. In between the project development, if there is an innovation which is turning up, there is a new idea which is turning up, where to adopt, in what way it has to be adopted, does it consume most of my time or can I meet within the deadline, are also to be considered. So, then it becomes an open paradigm. We have something called a synchronous paradigm, where it structures the team using natural compartmentalization of problem. This team work on the piece of problem by establishing proper communication among them. So, this all of these activities should happen in synchronization, meaning the members associated with the development or the people who got associated with the entire phase of development should be synchronously working on the same, building the same shape of the project, building same quality of the project. So, the communication has to happen properly so that it meets the requirement in the same format. What can happen wrong? After looking at these four paradigms, where can it go wrong? The main issue might come from the coordination and communications. So, in terms of scaling the activity, the scale of development efforts may be very large, which leads to complexity and confusion. So, looking at 1 lakh lines of code, initially having written 100 lines of code, people might be comfortable that this is the way in which we have to develop, but then going over the period, people might find it very difficult, where they get confusion most of the times and the problem might look even more complex than what they have assumed initially. So, at that time, we may need lot of coordination that should happen so that it can be taken to the next level. And there is a possibility of uncertainty too. Continuous changes occur in the project, due to which uncertainty is becoming more common in the modern softwares. And there is an issue of interoperability, where key characteristics of many systems, new software must be able to communicate with the existing software. So, if I try to establish a link between the older version of the software and the new version of the software, it should be interoperable. The operating system that is matching with the older versions with the current new version should also be manageable. So, how do we meld the product and the process? So, project planning begins with melding the product and the process. Each function to be engineered by the software team must pass through a set of framework activities that have been defined for the software organization. In short, in this particular session, what we have been looking at is to execute the project in a proper way, the management should support for four basic pieces, which are supposed to be the essential criteria, starting from people, process, project and product. And we have also looked at the roles and responsibilities which every people has to or every person has to make it out during the phase of software development. And we have also further pointed out with saying, how do we meld both the process and product together? Process are a sequence of activities which helps in the product development. So, how do we meld the product and the process is also being discussed here. Thank you.